starting lineup.
Good evening, everyone. We welcome you back to another edition of Knights Broadcasting. It's another beautiful evening in Buena Vista, Virginia, and we're at Knights Stadium for a matchup of NCAA Division III Women's Lacrosse featuring the visiting Randolph-Macon Yellow Jackets and, of course, your Southern Virginia University Knights. My name is Quinn Meyer, and I'll be here with you tonight all along with our stellar production crew at Knights Broadcasting. And so we get the starting lineups read here. Randolph-Macon, the Yellow Jackets, out of the Old Dominion Athletic Conference. Preseason picked number 4. Another familiar face to the Knights, not too far from Buena Vista in Ashland, Virginia. You can see the Yellow Jackets wearing their road blacks and the Knights in their home white uniforms. As the Knights are going to look to win consecutive games for the first time this season, this will be their fourth official matchup this season. They come into today with a record of 2-1, hot off the victory against Wittenberg. It was a double overtime thriller. And of course, again, the Knights are in their first year under recently hired head coach Olivia Cope. Most recently, the head coach at Bountiful High School, also served as an assistant to Brigham Young University's women's program in 2019 as well. Obviously, the program has experienced a lot of departures after last season, a team that made it all the way to the championship game of the USA South, just being edged out by Meredith. So a lineup that doesn't include much depth, but they'll have to rely on their starters more than ever. Kaya Baisden and Piper Searle are two of those starters from last year that return and are playing a big role in the team's success so far this year, both netting 11 goals to this point. Piper Searle had a big game against Wittenberg to propel them to a victory. Also, Kenzie Poulsen, the local freshman, has been a big addition as well, potting 5 goals so far in just 3 games. Then also, very notably is, or very, very noticeable is Roxy LeBaron, who's coming back for her senior season on the defensive side of things. As they'll Knights will look to ride this wave of momentum that they gained from that double overtime victory over Wittenberg. It knocked Wittenberg from the ranks of the undefeated here in Knight Stadium just a few days ago. But this should be a very tough matchup for the Knights as Randolph-Macon again. It was mentioned that they are preseason number 4 in the Old Dominion Athletic Conference, the ODAC, which historically boasts some pretty powerful programs. The Yellow Jackets are pretty close to closing out their non-conference schedule. Right now they boast a 3-2 record, have yet to start their schedule of ODAC play. They'll start that at home against Washington and Lee, the number 8 ranked team in the country right now. That was the team that eliminated them from the ODAC tournament last year in the semifinal. As both teams will head back towards the middle, as Addison England will be on the draw for Southern Virginia. Just finished up with the men's lacrosse game. Southern Virginia was hosting Messiah University. Messiah came out on top on that one, but the Knights women's lacrosse will try to flip the script tonight and get off to a good start. And lots of contact, 4 athletes going after it. Right off the draw is Addison England, who's able to scoop it up high in towards the side of the Yellow Jackets. We do have an athlete down, so we'll get the athletic trainers out to perhaps check on her, as she was, I think, about 2 or 3 players. One of them was her teammate, spilled over top of her as those players sprawled for that loose ball. And so she'll get taken out just a few seconds into this one. And hopefully she'll find her way back in eventually as we are just getting things started here, but a very active start indeed. I do believe the Knights will retain possession here. Kai Basin was one of those athletes running after it. 11 goals previously mentioned on the season that lead the team along with Piper Searle. As Addison England's going to feed Kai Basin. And she'll assess. Addison England's going to get that back from Roxy LeBaron. You'll see Addison England on the draws a lot. She takes most of them for the Knights. There's a good feed for Kai Basin in solo. She scores! Quick start for the Knights. Kai Basin going in solo in front of the keeper. And it's 1-0 Southern Virginia. There's a nice feed she got from Addison England. And that is exactly what the Knights wanted to start with against a very competitive opponent tonight in Randolph-Macon. That's Emma Taylor in goal for the Yellow Jackets. She's played every minute of every game so far in the five games they've played. Of course, not quite the start she was looking for, but it was a tough shot to handle as Kai Basin, the late leading scorer, came in all alone as the Yellow Jackets try to counter now. It was Rihanna Lowry with it. She's behind the goal being guarded by Roxy LeBaron. There's a good steal from the Knights. That was Bailey Bruce, I believe. The Yellow Jackets able to get it back. Evie McNeely, one of the leading scorers of the Yellow Jackets. She'll go back behind the goal, below the goal line, as they'll assess. Loft that high up for Taylor Middlestadter. I'm just going to fly over top of the crossbar. They do rule that a shot. Just release that a bit early. And the Yellow Jackets come calling again. And there's a good first save. It was going to go wide. But a good start defensively for Southern Virginia to stave off that Yellow Jackets attack. And again, that's freshman Madison Sorensen in goal. Just as Taylor for the Yellow Jackets, Sorensen has played every minute of every game between the pipes for Southern Virginia so far. Again, we talked about a lack of depth for this Knights squad this year, after the departure of head coach Rainey Whitworth. But Sorensen certainly will just have to ride the wave in goal this year, as there's not too much help behind her. That one's going to go just past Addison England. Sorensen has to go back towards her goal, but a couple of Knights are back on it. This is Piper Searle, also 11 goals on the season. And she'll hand that one off for Bailey Bruce, who moves it ahead for Roxy LeBaron. Lots of speed going right past a defender, then cuts back towards the middle. He's looking for a shot, but has to go back outside. Now Addison England. Looking for Michaela Martin on the near side. She's pressured by a defender and has to come back outside with it. Looking inside, that one was rejected by a Yellow Jacket defender. And the Knights will reset. Cutting back the middle, that's Poulsen, but stolen by the Yellow Jackets, able to scoop it back off the turf. And they'll look to get it out of harm's way as Taylor, the goalie, moves it ahead for her defender. Taylor Middlestadter, move it ahead, Yellow Jackets with a 4-on-5 rush. Good weaving through the middle, good save made by Sorensen. Sorensen, two early saves for the freshman. This is Kaya Basin moving back through, the only goal scorer so far on the evening. She's going to pull up and let her attack get set. Now Piper Searle. Nice cut back towards the middle looking for an opening, but that's swatted away by Taylor. And she'll wait for some friends to get open, and send it back into the middle. This is Roxy LeBaron giving chase. Now moved ahead for Emma Moxham. There's a pass towards the middle for a cutting team bit, and she's going to score. Pretty play. I believe that was Annie Bartley to put that one in. A good play by Moxham to find her streaking down the middle. And they put it by Sorensen for their first one of the evening, just under 4.5 minutes into play. And Annie Bartley is one of their leading scorers. 14 goals on the season so far. Part of a core of players for the Yellow Jackets that returned from last year. So it's a very exciting season for Randolph-Macon as they approach conference play in the ODAC. It'll be Addison England again on the draw for Southern Virginia. This is Bartley able to pick it up. She's given lots of space by Huntsman. But now Huntsman pressures and Bartley is forced to circle back behind the cage. Looks for a streaking teammate. She might have had her, but Bailey Bruce was in the vicinity to disrupt the option. Looks like an attacker for the Yellow Jackets was tripped up. It might have been Roxy LeBaron going off. And she'll be assessed a yellow on that one. And that'll put the Yellow Jackets with their first opportunity on the man advantage. So a free position opportunity, first one of the night, and she scores. Good solo effort that time. It is Amanda Maxwell getting on the board to give the Yellow Jackets their first lead of the evening. So a pretty promising start for the Knights after they opened up with a Kai-based and goal and a couple of clutch saves from Madison Sorensen, but Yellow Jackets able to counter with that speed and draw a penalty and put themselves in lead 2-1. Head coach M.K. Giertowski is in charge for the 11th season and counting. Just recently surpassed 100 wins, I believe. So our congratulations to her. It certainly has this Yellow Jackets team trending in a good direction early in the season. Again, as we approach conference play, but Piper Searle, a nice aggressive play to grab hold of that one. He's going to set up Kinsey Poulsen, promising freshman 5 goals on the year so far. Pass from Poulsen wasn't handled by Bangerter, but I believe they will retain possession as they played right along the line there, and there will be a foul, I believe, as Bangerter keeps control and will send it back for Poulsen. Looks for a lane, then pulls back to the far side. Addison England comes calling, but she doesn't go her way. But still looking for someone streaking down the middle. Randolph-Macon does have very quick and speedy defenders to disrupt those options. Kai Bazin almost made a nifty sidestep back to the inside. She does pick this one up after a possible turnover. And the play is blown dead as the shot clock also had reset. Have the official heading back towards the middle of the field, waiting to get word on what the stoppage was for. Again, the Knights coming off of a 12-6 season, 8-1 in the USA South, eventually fell to the tournament champions Meredith in a thriller. They had two thrilling games, one of those being here at Knights Stadium in Buena Vista. Just one goal separated the Knights from Meredith. And a pretty similar game followed in that championship match. The Knights trying to replicate some success from last season to this year. This is Piper Searle for Addison England. Nice move around the defender. Goes back towards the middle. Now shoots it. Good save made by Emma Taylor. As she will settle things down. That was a good rush there by Addison England, showing lots of strength as she had a couple of defenders draped all over her. This is Lily Fowler. Lots of speed. She looks towards the middle, but that's blocked by Huntsman. So they'll opt to just reset back at the top of things, just about 20 yards outside the goal. Taylor Middlestadter. That angle was cut off by the combination of England and Bailey Bruce. They'll reset and look for some more space inside. Just 35 seconds remain on the shot clock. Bit of a miscommunication there. Still up for grabs. Good job by Roxy LeBaron to challenge. Or correction, I believe that's Ellie Patterson who disrupted that play. So a good defensive stand by Southern Virginia, and they have yet another opportunity to knot things at two. This is Mariela Perez. Crossing midfield. Surrounded by a couple of Yellow Jacket defenders. And moves it along for Reagan Bullock. That one deflects off of a stick. Good steal by Annie Bartley. And she has the Yellow Jackets back in control. She faces pressure from Bailey Bruce, but able to gather. And find for some space for her team. Now Emma Moxon. Assisted on that first goal from Annie Bartley. McNeely leaves it back. Good defense there by Ellie Patterson. A good pass back towards the middle. Now it'll cut to the middle of the field. That's cut off by a couple of Knight defenders. Addison England in the vicinity. Just 45 seconds remain on the shot clock now. Good pass in the middle. There's a good save from Sorensen. Went off the shin. Yellow Jackets do pick it up, and that shot clock will reset. Full 90 back on the clock for the Yellow Jackets. Or full 60, rather. Just 9 minutes gone in this first frame. Randolph-Macon leads Southern Virginia 2-1. Yellow Jackets threatening. There's a goal. Good pass to the middle from Annie Bartley. She finds Evie McNeely. And just like that, 3-1 in favor of Randolph-Macon. Similar to what we saw in the men's game just a couple of hours ago. Now, Knights going toe-for-toe with the opponent for the first few possessions. And after getting off to a quick start from the goal by Kaya Basden, Knights haven't really been able to muster much at all on the offensive side of things, and that's three consecutive goals for Randolph-Macon to extend their lead back to two. It'll be Elena Creekmore and Addison England on the draw again. That call is going to go the way of Creekmore, and she speeds into the zone. Past Reagan Bullock, right towards the goal. Sorensen had the angle, as well as Bailey Bruce. Nice sidestep, but defended well. And there's a Yellow Jacket right out in front, all alone. Wasn't able to handle the pass because she had a slam dunk. as they do on the other side here. Another good save from Sorensen, and she's able to cover and get it to Ellie Patterson here on the near side. Patterson will try and escape harm. So look far side for Reagan Bullock. And she will escape into the Yellow Jackets defensive zone and reset for Kai Basin. Lone goal scorer on the evening for Southern Virginia. Looking to find some space. She does. Ducks under defender. And a couple of the Yellow Jackets ran right into each other. And they both look to be just fine. Maybe just a bit of a stinger as they might have clanged knees. As Kaya Basin moved through, there was a foul on the play, so a free opportunity for Kaya Basin. She'll move in solo, gets checked from behind, and she'll put it over top of the crossbar. Here's Piper Searle taking a whack at it, but Yellow Jackets will look to escape their zone with Emma Taylor, the goalie. And then they'll speed it ahead into the night zone. That was Roxy LeBaron giving chase. Looked like Elena Creekmore might have had a step in the middle of the field. They don't see her, and will reset behind the goal line. This is Creekmore again. McNeely leaves it down low towards the goal line. She'll get it back. Not able to handle the pass, and Roxy LeBaron cleans it up. LeBaron able to successfully cross over that line and send it back for England. Now Piper Searle in control as the Knights get the set on their offense. This is Bullock. Finds a lane through the middle, but she's converged on by about three Yellow Jacket defenders. Still up for grabs now. Michaela Martin going after it. And there's a good defensive play again by the Yellow Jackets after that first early goal from Kaya Basden. Not much, allowing much at all in the way of offense for the Knights. And I think that's a call being made on Michaela Martin, I believe. As that was Amanda Maxwell cradling the ball, trying to find her way out of the defensive zone. And it will be Martin. The Yellow Jackets to sky that one into the attacking zone. And it'll reset with Lily Fowler. Back up top they go. Another opening down low, bounces it just in front of Sorensen and back out of bounds. They'll retain control with 65 left on the shot clock. Open chance, and they're going to score, coming from behind the net. Able to win a foot race against McKaylee Huntsman. It is now 4-1 in favor of Randolph-Macon. Looked to be Lily Fowler, who was able to make a run out in front of the crease and really found herself all alone. No Knight defender within 10 or 15 feet of her. And that's going to beat Sorensen, who has had a solid start to the afternoon. Made a couple of really nice saves to keep the Knights in the lead 1-0 early on, but four consecutive goals by Randolph-Macon has put the pressure on Southern Virginia towards the end of the first quarter. Addison England back for the draw. Randolph-Macon will win that one. right along the goal line now. As Bailey Bruce watches closely, but the whistle is blown. We'll see what the word on that one is. As a green card looks to be assessed by the official up high, right around where Kenzie Poulsen and that's Abby Dietrich, I believe, of Randolph-Macon. And it will be, that's Reagan Bullock of the Knights going off. So she'll take a few moments on the sideline trying to get some clarification from the official what went wrong there in that play. So it looks to be another man advantage for Randolph-Macon. They scored on their earlier advantage. It does look like Bullock will stay. There's just a little bit of confusion over there by the scoring table and the official, but Yellow Jackets back on the attack. Good pressure being applied by Patterson's. Had a couple of good defensive plays in the early going. There's a good steal up for grabs. Patterson had it, but lost it. Still loose, just a few yards in front of Sorensen. Looked like McNeely, who was able to pick it up before the play was blown dead. So I think it'll be her, McNeely, with a free position opportunity just to the right of Madison Sorensen. She'll opt back up top. Well guarded by the Knights. And there's a shot off the post. That was number two, Taylor Middlestadter. Rifled that one off the right post, and it goes just about 20, 30 yards to the right of Sorensen. But the Yellow Jackets will be able to reset their offense with a fresh clock. Looking back towards the middle. Good play by Huntsman, but it will be whistled down. As it looked as if Kaylee Huntsman made a quality defensive play. As the attacker looked to drive back towards the middle and free up some space between Huntsman and the keeper. But again, one-on-one with Sorensen. This time she'll go in solo and put it past Sorensen. Nice looking shot from Cammie McNeely. And it is 5-1 Randolph-Macon with 1:23 to go in the first frame. Having a discussion in front of the goal, trying to see how they can adjust better on these Yellow Jacket attacks. They had a couple of good defensive stances earlier on in the first quarter, but since then it's been all Yellow Jackets that they now claim a 4-goal lead, and they'll try to take that and extend it into the first quarter break. This is Kaya Basin able to grab it, but she then loses it. Basin's had a pretty good bounce to her early on, but that'll be a turnover. It's ruled a foul on base, and there on the far sideline, almost forced out of bounds that time, but then another call made, and a green card assessed, I think, Kai Bays, and that'll be her to sit out just a few moments. So Bays will be out for a minute. Won't be able to come back, but a nice looking steal that time. This is Kinsey Poulsen, the freshman, once again. Looking for space to operate, and she'll opt back for Bangerter. And now Roxy LeBaron, the senior, in control. It's Michaela Martin here on the near side. She'll go back towards the middle and switch places with Addison England. Michaela Martin looks near side for England again. Bobble that one, but has it back. Good feed looking for Piper Searle, but picked up by Emma Taylor. Good awareness to clean up the mess in front. And she'll look to clear. Just 15 seconds to go in the first quarter as the Yellow Jackets try to extend that lead before the buzzer goes. They'll cut back towards the middle. I think this is McNeely on it. Good pass inside, and they're going to score just before the buzzer. 6-1 now. Randolph making a nice feed. That was Cammie McNeely going inside. Found the open teammate and puts it past Sorensen for a 6-1 lead. We had thought the time would not be on the side of Randolph-Macon on that last rush, as Southern Virginia did have the opportunity to run the clock down, but a turnover off the stick of Piper Searle allowed Emma Taylor, the keeper for Randolph-Macon, to find someone ahead. It was Cammie McNeely who made a nice swift pass back towards the middle. And just like that, a 6-1 lead, last draw of the first quarter. Addison England looks to win that one as the buzzer goes. Can't gather it. So both teams will head to the benches and assess their first quarter. 6-1 again the score. Randolph-Macon in control after the Knights had bounced to an early 1-0 lead. But at this time before the start of the second quarter, the Southern Virginia Athletics Program wants to thank the following sponsors for their continued support of Knights Athletics and show our appreciation for them. Those sponsors being Cornerstone Bank, Straws, Drinks and Eats, River Crossing Apartments, Vinyl Cuts, Grace Automotive, The Beeve, Mill Creek Orthodontics, Papa John's, and Katana Hibachi and Sushi Express. And Grace Automotive, of course, offers 10% discount to all students and staff of Southern Virginia. And then it's quite well known at this point for those local to the Buena Vista area. But for those tuning in who are unaware, Straws, Drinks, and Eats on Magnolia Avenue offers plenty of fun and activities each Friday at 7 p.m. So in a couple of nights, start your weekend off at Straws and get yourself a nice drink and snack and enjoy the fun at Straws, Drinks, and Eats. So it looked promising early on in the first for Southern Virginia after Kaya Basin struck just about 15 or 20 seconds into this one. But since then, it has been all Randolph-Macon turning some pretty good defense into even better offense to extend their advantage to 6-1. Also thanks to a last-second goal from Avery McNeely, assisted by her sister, that would be Cammie McNeely. As both teams head out and, of course, switch sides. And going back to Madison Sorensen, the goalkeeper for Southern Virginia, really has been, you know, thrust into the spotlight for this year, her freshman campaign. Only goalie on the roster, I believe, after the departure of the goalies last year for the Knights, who were in that regular rotation, including Jessica Webb and Morgan Bunch, among others. Did a fabulous job for Southern Virginia last year. Led them to a very solid season that saw them go 12-6 and 8-1 in conference play before losing in the final to Meredith. Kaya Basin able to pick that one up, lots of speed. Gets it to Addison England, but she can't handle the pass. But Basin just able to bully her way past the defender and pick up the loose change. But so far, Sorensen, goalie for Southern Virginia, has done a very admirable job against some really stiff competition, including Randolph-Macon, one of the better teams in the very difficult Old Dominion Athletic Conference. Features teams such as the number 8 ranked team in the country, Washington and Lee, among others. Southern Virginia, good control. This is Roxy LeBaron. She'll send it back over for Addison England. Good pass into the middle, looking for Michaela Martin, She turned, looking to buy some time, but she ran into a couple of more defenders. Now picking up, I believe, was Kaya Baisden in the middle, but she's tripped up, and a call will be made. So that will free her up for an opportunity just to the left of Emma Taylor. Baisden looking for two on the night. She'll go right towards Taylor and gets it knocked out of her stick. Good defensive play again by the Yellow Jackets, and it bounces right to Taylor, who will clear it out for the Yellow Jackets. Macon still trying to find their way out of the zone. There's a good steal by Roxy LeBaron. Been a very key part to this roster for 4 years now in her season's senior year out of Crossfield, Alberta. That one hits a Yellow Jacket defender. Roxy LeBaron still going after it. Now it's Kaya Baisden getting involved. That will be whistled down against the Knights. And so a promising turnover caused by LeBaron turns into a Yellow Jackets opportunity back the other way again. Back behind the goal now. About 20 seconds through the shot clock. Yellow Jackets looked like they might have missed a chance cutting through the middle, but now it's Mittelstadter in control. One-on-one with Addison England. There's a shot just past the left post. Sorensen had most of that side of the net covered, so good positioning from her to force that wide from Mittelstadter. Here's McNeely again. Good pressure by Ellie Patterson, guarding her face up. Now there's Annie Prout involved as well. She'll move back towards the near side, as now it's below the goal line once again. This is Perez just shadowing Rihanna Lowry. She'll opt back towards the far side. There's a good play towards the middle. Good save from Sorensen off the sharp angle shot. That one's going to bounce past Kaylee Mulligan. She didn't know where it was. Good job to stay inbounds by number 13, Lydia Lesnovich. Yellow Jackets looking to counter after their own turnover. Emma Moxham goes back down low now. And below the goal line. 30 seconds remain on the shot clock, so it didn't reset after that. That almost changed in possession. Says Mulligan again. Now just 15 on the shot clock. McNeely behind the goal again. Says Lowry looking for some space. She'll almost lose it. Looking for a pass towards the middle. They get it. Just three on the shot clock, but they're going to be bailed out by a call. I think they might be getting Ellie Patterson, who laid a check on, could have been Kemi McNeely. I'm not quite sure. It's hard to tell which number is which. That is McNeely. Good save from Sorensen. Either caught her or the right post, and Kaya Baisden streaking back down the field on the attack. She's got some room looking for Kinsey Poulsen down the middle. Michaela Martin looked to have a step on that near side. But they'll slow things down as Kinsey Poulsen able to recover and grab control. Now for Bangerter and then Baisden. Just under 5 minutes gone in the second quarter of play. Still 6-1. No goal scored in the second quarter. Piper Searle trying to get on the board for the first time. Baisden, good recovery after she was challenged by, that might have been Moxham or Amanda Maxwell, 22. Looking for some space is Piper Searle. Around the circle she goes. She's going to get it back after she was forced outside of that arc. Now Kaya Basden with it. Basden again, looking for some teammates down the middle. Kinsey Poulsen tries to go that direction, but converged on is Kaya Basden by two Yellow Jacket defenders. Looks to be Maxwell. They're trying to plead their case, but a call will be made by the official just a few yards away. Just 10 seconds remain on the shot clock. Here comes Piper Searle. She's going to lose it. Basden looks to grab control again. They're going to have to put up a shot if they do grab control, but it's taken by the Yellow Jacket defenders, and they're moving quickly back past midfield, trying to get into that attacking zone. They do before Bangerter has to pull up. It's Cammie McNeely. Had that last free position opportunity. Turned into a good save by Sorensen. And now Maxwell. Elena Creekmore. Good defense from Addison England. As they'll just make their way around the ring. This is Kaylee Mulligan now looking for space. Again, good defense that time from Reagan Bullock. Good steal. Ellie Patterson able to anticipate that one very nicely. She's got a couple of teammates to the right of her. She's going to set up Bangerter. And back on the attack they go. This is Piper Searle looking for space. She's going to sky that one over top of the crossbar. Sprinting to get there first is Piper Searle, but also perhaps Michaela Martin in the vicinity. And they will win that race and retain control. Piper Searle back for England. Into the middle, cutting back towards the outside. And they'll go back down low for Bangerter. Good job to tippy-toe along that line and stay in bounds. An ill-advised pass, though, that time from Bangerter, and the Yellow Jackets able to pick it up. They'll circle back and look for some more space to advance. This is Jordan Schwartz, number one in control. Addison England gives chase, and another successful clearance that time. As there's a check that Kaya Basden gives, that was number four that time, and a snutty. Good defense that time by Perez. Yellow Jackets looks towards the middle. This is Bartley. She's forced back outside. Now down low, back up top now for Taylor Middlestadter. Schwartz, good pass, top shelf there for Middlestadter. Great pass by Schwartz. And that'll be the first goal of the second quarter, just under 9 minutes into this one, so it took a while, but Randolph-Macon on the board for the first time in the second frame. That'll make it 7-1 in favor of Randolph-Macon. After the Knights had a few minutes of sustained pressure, but a couple of ill-advised passes turned back the other way for Randolph-Macon. So the Knights still looking for a way to boost their momentum and claw their way back into this one. Randolph-Macon also really dominating in the shot category. 17 shots compared to Southern Virginia's 4. So it makes a little more sense to what the scoreboard reads. Certainly going to need more shots than that if you're Southern Virginia. They've had opportunities and have received some good passes into the middle in front of Emma Taylor, but just have not been able to get anything on goal or really get anything released for that matter. There's been some really good defensive sticks from Randolph making good feet inside, looking for Banger for Mittelstadter again. That's going to bounce into the safety of Madison Sorensen, and Perez leads the Knights back out. Bailey Bruce looking near side. Good job by Ellie Patterson to stay in bounds. Trying to find her way through a couple of attackers from Randolph-Macon, one of those being Annie Bartley, their leading scorer on the year. Just 5:10 remaining in the second quarter, and there's a pick from Randolph-Macon. Back the other way they go. Sorensen having to backpedal towards her own goal. Lots of speed going towards Sorensen, and she's going to hold up as Sorensen did a good job of forcing her wide left. But then another dangerous pass back towards the middle that the Knights were fortunate to stave off. That was Rihanna Lowry with a real nice burst to get by three Knight defenders and found herself in alone with Madison Sorensen. Good play by Kai Bast, and on the attack she goes. Lots of speed again. She's got a Baron to her right. Poulsen down the middle to her left. She's going to opt to slow things down as Roxy LeBaron will think it over and find Poulsen below the goal line behind the net. Kenzie Poulsen once again here on the near side. Bottom corner of your screen. Now LeBaron. Lots of speed. Banger going towards the middle. Upended. And there will be a call made. She was just to the left of Emma Taylor. And that certainly will be a free position opportunity this time for Piper Searle. Looking for her first. Good save by Emma Taylor. Looked like Searle might have not been able to get all the power she wanted on that one. There's a good pursuit made by Bangerter before she has to pull up at the line. Randolph making on the attack. There's a feed for Bartley inside. Scores! Annie Bartley able to sky over top of the two defenders and put it past Sorensen right over her shoulder and give Macon an 8-1 lead now with 3:26 remaining in the first half of play. So again, another opportunity to put one on the board for Southern Virginia. Turns into points back the other way for the Yellow Jackets. That time it was Piper Searle on that free position opportunity. It was a good save by Emma Taylor, who's been doing the job here after that quick start from Kai Basden in the first. But since then, it's been all Yellow Jackets. Another draw. This has been dominated for the most part by Randolph-Macon. Kai Basden almost able to get to that one first. Now a loose ball. Good job by the Yellow Jackets to get loose. That might be Maxwell. Again, a little tough to see the numbers at in some parts of the field and where the ladies are positioned, so we apologize if getting anyone's names wrong at any point. Nice move back towards the middle. There's a goal scored from, that's number 11, Rihanna Lowry, who we've seen had a couple of really nice bursts. That one from behind the goal, back out in front and puts it past Sorensen. Two quick goals after a slow start to this second quarter. 9-1 now for the Yellow Jackets. The Knights really in need of some sort of response at this point. It starts with finding a way to get this draw control. Addison England has come close many times to coming out on top when they need it. After these now 9 consecutive goals scored by Randolph-Macon. But they really need one here to find a way to close out the second quarter strong. Under 3 minutes remaining before halftime. That time it went towards Piper Searle, but straight into the possession of Emma Moxon. It was Emma Moxon who was able to grab control of that last draw, number 28 of Randolph-Macon. And they'll look to put double digits on the scoreboard before halftime. Now Moxon. It's just Schwartz. Got room. Good save, Sorensen. Ellie Patterson tries to clean it up against two. Randolph-Macon attacker. She'll lose that battle. Now looking for some space down the middle are the Yellow Jackets. That was Bartley looking to go towards the goal, but she'll opt to go back outside that outside arc. This is Schwartz once again. Nice spin move, but she'll be cut off by Mariela Perez. Now Moxon again. Nice feed inside. Scores again. What a feed for Moxon inside from below the goal line. And that'll be double digits on the board for the Yellow Jackets. 10-1 now the score. Yellow Jackets really able to spread the wealth here late in the second quarter. It was a slow start again. 6-1 was the score at the end of the first quarter, and it was that way for most of the second quarter until around the 5-minute mark or so. But Macon's offense has really exploded here in the last few minutes and has put double digits on the board now, and they're going to now look for a double-digit lead here late in the first half. Was Emma Moxon again, assisted that time by Amanda Maxwell. Rihanna Lowry had the goal previous before that one. And it looked as if England almost won that one, but she's going to be called. And this will be in possession of Randolph-Macon yet again. But tough break for Addison England. Not really able to get anything to bounce her way so far in those draws. There's just Schwartz back in control. Game clock pretty close to being even with the shot clock. There is Bartley again, and she scores. She's been quiet during this quarter, but this time explodes into the middle of the field and rifles it to the left or the right of Madison Sorensen. And it is now 11-1. As there's now under a minute to play in the first half. As they keep this clock rolling. Refs trying to hurry on back to the middle of the field for this draw. It will be Addison England again. We'll see if she has a little bit better luck this time again against Elena Creekmore, who's done very well tonight. Creekmore again able to win it. Able to loft that one up high for Middlestadt. Just 15 seconds on the clock until halftime. Bartley looking towards the middle. She could have pulled the trigger but opts to go back. Nice feed inside, and that one is blocked. I believe Ellie Patterson getting to it. And then it's into the safety of Madison Sorensen before halftime. The clock goes down to zero. And that'll do it for the first half of play. A pretty even second quarter until the last few minutes where Macon was able to explode for 5 goals and extend their advantage to 11-1. And with that, we'll head to a brief 10-minute intermission in between halves. Again, you're watching this on Night Broadcasting, be sure to like, subscribe, leave a comment, let us know how we're doing that and how we can improve your viewing experience. And please don't go away. Make sure to join us again in just about 10 minutes for the second half of play.
It's been 18 years. You gotta make it up somehow. Wild. That was a blast. When you have all access like I do.
And we welcome everyone back for the second half of action at today's women's lacrosse matchup between the visiting Randolph-Macon Yellow Jackets and your Southern Virginia University Knights. If you're following along on our live stats, you can see Randolph-Macon really dominated that first half of play, despite the Knights getting off to a quick start in the first 20-25 seconds of that first quarter when Kaya Baisden struck to give the Knights a 1-0 lead. But since then, the Knights have had a tough time mustering anything offensively, as there's another steal from Randolph-Macon right off the hop before the Knights can establish their sets. Quick feed ahead for McNeely. Tries to go around the defender, but she's blocked off of that angle. As you can tell, Knights trying to cover any seams that develop. Cutting right down the middle in front of Sorensen. Sorensen also had a good start to this one, just as her teammates did offensively. A couple of really big saves to keep the Knights in the lead for a few minutes, but a really strong into that first quarter as well as the second quarter has vaulted the Yellow Jackets into an 11-1 lead, and they're looking to expand on that here. Nice feed down low, and there's a goal just inside the post for Randolph-Macon. Looks to be Evie McNeely. Another feed streaking down the middle. And just a minute and 20 gone in the second half. And Randolph-Macon has their advantage at 11. 12-1 now the count. They'll come back towards the middle. This is Middlestadter. In England, they'll do battle in this draw. England had some pretty tough luck, you could say, in the first half. As there's another one up high, and there's a good retrieval. Looks to be from Kaya Basden. But a good defensive play to almost grab it. Now it's loose. Still looking for control was Eva McNeely. She's upended. But the Yellow Jackets back on the attack. So another pretty good effort in the draw from Addison England. She comes up empty again. Kaya Basden not able to grab control of that one. Nice feed inside, and another goal for Randolph-Macon. As it appeared, Sorensen might have been able to see that out of the corner of her eye, but a really quick switch down low. An even better pass to give Randolph-Macon their 13th on the evening. That's Taylor Middlestadter again. A beauty of a feed from Lily Fowler as they head back for the draw. So not the start the Knights wanted in the second half. They certainly started a lot better in that second quarter, as well as the first, obviously, with that early goal from Kaya Basden. But the second quarter, they were able to hold off the Yellow Jackets for about 10 minutes before they exploded for 5 goals in the final few minutes. Knights do win a draw. Good job again by Addison England to stay with it. And Knights are now in the attacking zone. And this is Kenzie Poulsen. And it backs into Reagan Bullock, who scoots out of her way. Now it's back for Hannah Bangerter. Looking for Michaela Martin here on the near side. She misses the pass. But looking to pick it up was Addison England, but she will not get there in time. So another turnover from Southern Virginia. As they're looking for a lot of longer passes from below the goal, and it seems like they might need to shorten those passes a little bit to prevent any of those unforced errors. Because that turnover is just gift-wrapped for Randolph-Macon. As they try to make their way back into the attacking zone. Picked up again. That was Maxwell. And Emma Moxon going towards the middle. Nice feed to the other side, but it's mishandled. But no Knights in the vicinity to challenge, so McNeely will send it back up top. 10 minutes now to go. Rolling clock now in this matchup. Here's McNeely again. Nice cut swerving to the left side. She'll look back outside for help. Again, another cutting athlete down the middle. And there's a check from Ellie Patterson. And she looks to be called. I'm not sure if it was Patterson or Perez, it looked like, is going off. As that was number 3. Cutting through, I believe, for Randolph-Macon. It might have gotten a stick to the head or that shoulder area. Foul was on Perez. Another free opportunity for Randolph-Macon. Nice pass inside, and there's another goal for the Yellow Jackets. Unexpected pass towards the goal line just to the right of Sorensen. Couldn't react in time to cut the pass off. And that'll be another goal, 14, for Randolph-Macon on the night. There's Evie McNeely again, able to convert. wait for this draw to take place. Just 8.5 minutes remain in the third quarter. Looks like it might be Ellie Patterson getting her first crack at a draw. She'll end up losing that one again to Creekmore, who's been money in the draw so far for Randolph-Macon. She'll try to do it herself. She'll opt to circle back and look for a teammate. Going right down the middle. Fake shot back towards the left side. And then canceled out by a defender. And they'll reset. Around the ring they go. Nice feed inside. Another goal for Randolph-Macon. As the Knights are really starting to lose track of those attackers cutting through the middle from the Yellow Jackets. As Randolph-Macon able to put 15 on the board now. Look to be McNeely, this time Kemi McNeely, assisted by Katie Benton. Knights trying to search for something to get them going again, garner some sort of momentum. They seem to have a bit of a jump in the early going, but it's just been taken away from this really hot start to the second half by the Yellow Jackets. That's Ellie Patterson again on the draw. She's able to make contact as Creekmore's going after it. Patterson still in pursuit, but a good play by the Yellow Jackets to get it past midfield, and they're back on the attack. It certainly can wear on the defense when they're in front of their own goal for so long. It's easy to lose focus of where those athletes are cutting, which is maybe a good reason as to why these offensive possessions aren't taking as long as they did in the first half. There's another cut back towards the middle. Another score for Randolph-Macon as she's falling down. There was a penalty being called as the shot was released, it looked like. That was number 4, Anna Snoddy. Patterson will head back towards the draw. Face off with Taylor Middlestadter again. Who has stepped in for Creekmore, who did battle with Addison England for the majority of that first half. Up high it goes again. Looked to be another recovery for Middlestadter, but a whistle blown in favor of the Yellow Jackets. They'll pick it up, but then called right back to slow it down. As I believe a timeout was called by Southern Virginia, I believe. As both teams will head back to their respective benches. And at this time, again, the Knights Athletic Department wants to thank the following sponsors for their continued support of Knights Athletics. And in return, wants to give them a shout-out here on our Knights broadcasts. Those sponsors being Cornerstone Bank, Straws Drinks and Eats, River Crossing Apartments, Vinyl Cuts, Grace Automotive, The Beeve, Mill Creek Orthodontics, Papa John's, and Katana Hibachi and Sushi Express. So please be sure to show your appreciation to those sponsors and be sure to support them in any way you can. They love all of our business here at Southern Virginia. And a good way to go out and help support the community here in the Shenandoah Valley. As we now come out of the timeout, Yellow Jackets back on the field waiting for the Knights. Well, a tough moment right now for Southern Virginia. It was a promising start to this one. Again, as previously mentioned many times, Kai Basin got the Knights off to a hot start with the first goal of the game. But Randolph-Macon has completely taken control, especially here in the second half. Knights were holding the Yellow Jackets off for most of that second quarter at just a 6-1 advantage. But really started to fall off the rails at that point, and this constant offensive pressure from Randolph-Macon certainly wears on the defenders of Southern Virginia. There is a good defensive play that time. Elliot Patterson able to scoop it up. And back on the attack comes Southern Virginia. There's Piper Searle out there looking for her first on the evening. Here comes Patterson trying to do it herself. She's got Michaela Martin on the near side. She'll leave it off for her. And they'll reset up top. Now Kai based and in control. Now Roxy LeBaron. And Addison England looking for Piper Searle down the middle. She's going to shoot, and she's going to get one. Nice looking shot, Piper Searle that time. And the Knights just needed one offensive opportunity, and they do score on it to put their second on the board of the evening. Good looking play there from Southern Virginia off a nice feed from, I believe that was Addison England. And an even better shot as Piper Searle wasn't completely open, but had that open side on the defender and puts it past Emma Taylor for her first on the evening and 12th on the year. Just 3:30 left in the third quarter. They sent Addison England back for the draw. She's going to win this one, then tripped up. Gets upended by Rihanna Lowry, it looked like. It was a pretty violent fall, but Addison looks to be up and okay. And as Lowry makes her way to the sideline to serve some time. This is Roxy LeBaron. Lots of speed through the middle, gets checked. Couple yards back. She looks to go back up top now for Kaya Basden. She'll look things over. Try to switch places with Ellie Patterson. A little bit up high there on Kaya Basden. No call made. Basden looks for Bullock. Had a chance to release, then is upended right down the middle. No call made. Still up for grabs now, and now the whistle blows, and it'll be in favor of Southern Virginia, I believe. As Regan Bullock had a pretty good opportunity right down the middle to release it right as she received that pass, but opted not to, and it almost ran into trouble. But another opportunity for Southern Virginia. This is Kai Basden right down the middle, and she puts it past Emma Taylor for her second of the evening and puts three on the board for the Knights. Couple of good and strong offensive possessions there for Southern Virginia. Results and goals from the ladies, who are your leading scorers. So good, strong play from Reagan Bullock. And then, of course, Kaya Basden to put that one in. To cut a little bit more into the lead of Randolph-Macon. And if anything, it's keeping the attackers of Randolph-Macon from advancing towards Madison Sorensen, which is the best thing you can do at this point if you're Southern Virginia, because that attack right now is just so lethal of the Yellow Jackets. You want to keep the ball on the other end of the field as long as you can. Just a minute 15 remaining in the third quarter. Bit of a trip there, and that will be called, so Randolph-Macon will bring it back just a few yards and get things going again. But those draw controls just show how important they are, as Addison England able to win one, and it turns into a goal the other way for Southern Virginia. That time lost it again, and certainly Randolph-Macon might just look to eat some clock and get the last shot in this quarter. There's a feed back towards the middle, and there's a goal past Sorensen. Maybe wasn't expecting the quick turnaround, And Randolph-Macon scores to get one back after two consecutive Southern Virginia goals. It's Amelia Davis on the score for Randolph-Macon, putting 17 on the board for them, and I think that'll have the third quarter come to a close. 1 second and counting, and both teams will head to their benches for the last time before the final frame. Randolph-Macon leading it 17-3 here in Buena Vista. And one final time, the Knights Athletic Department wants to show our appreciation for our athletic sponsors and their continued support in our athletic programs: Cornerstone Bank, Straws Drinks and Eats, River Crossing Apartments, Vinyl Cuts, Grace Automotive, The Beeve, Mill Creek Orthodontics, Papa John's, and Katana Hibachi and Sushi Express. So a performance like this from Randolph-Macon certainly is going to give them some mojo as they head towards their first game of conference play. They're also coming off of a loss, two consecutive losses actually, after winning their first three games on the season. One of those losses included a very hard-fought matchup with number 15-ranked Christopher Newport. That was in Newport News on February 28th. Yellow Jackets lost that one 14-9, but then were upended by Widener University on Sunday the 10th, just a few days ago, 9-6. But are putting on a show here in Buena Vista before they head to Raleigh, or correction, that's their home turf in Ashland, Virginia, to face Meredith for their final non-conference game before facing Washington and Lee at home. Of course, Washington and Lee, the number 8 ranked team in the country, to start play in the Old Dominion Athletic Conference, that being the ODAC, and will play competition from the ODAC for the rest of the season. Of course, the Knights also pretty close to ending their non-conference schedule. I have to draw quickly going after. It looks to be Roxy LeBaron. It's still loose. Good job to box out the attacker of the Yellow Jackets, so it's going to get loose for Kaya Basin, and on the attack she goes, trying to speed past the defender. Looks like she won't pull up this time. Tries to send it towards the goal. Looked like it might have been blocked. Or maybe it was a fake shot towards Emma Taylor, but the Knights do keep possession still. This is Piper Sir looking for her second on the evening. They go towards the goal. Good save by Emma Taylor. As the Knights were threatening in the first 40 seconds of the fourth and final frame. Yellow Jackets trying to convert on another clearance. And they almost lost control. Bailey Bruce didn't know where it was. Perhaps had a couple of teammates screaming at her of where it was. There's another goal for Randolph-Macon, speeding right down the lane. And again, Randolph-Macon off to a quick start in this fourth quarter. That was Anna Snoddy, I believe, putting in her second on the day. Again, this won't be the last non-conference game for Southern Virginia, but it will be the last before they start their conference schedule in the USA South. They'll face Piedmont here in Buena Vista at Knight Stadium on Saturday at 2 p.m., and then we'll face William Peace in Raleigh, North Carolina, a week after that, so we'll have some time to rest up and get ready for those games. But they will have a couple more non-conference games on their schedule, including games versus Bridgewater and Center, both those being here in Buena Vista at Knight Stadium. Ball up for grabs right in front of Emma Taylor as the Knights were back on the attack, but a good defensive play to scoop it up from Randolph-Macon. And they look to go back the other way, but peppered by about three Knight defenders, including Roxy LeBaron, able to almost force her out of bounds, but they will retain control. Yellow Jackets trying to mount another attack. Down low on the goal line. Trying to move around Huntsman, and she will. Another score. That time Schwartz, I believe, puts it past Sorensen to put 19 on the board for the Yellow Jackets. Again, Randolph-Macon doing a good job, just able to spread the wealth as they put a number of players who aren't typically in their starting lineup onto the turf and are producing some good results so far for Randolph-Macon here early in the fourth quarter. Just 3.5 minutes gone as another timeout will be taken. This one, I believe, again by Southern Virginia, so both teams will head back to their respective benches. But Evie McNeely, the game leader in goals, with 4. Then Annie Bartley has 3. And then a number of athletes with 2, including Kaya Basin of the Knights. And then, of course, Piper Searle chipped in there in the third quarter with a goal of her own. That was one of 2 consecutive goals that the Knights were able to score towards the end of that quarter. But as I was saying, the Knights will begin USA South Conference play here pretty soon. They were preseason number 4 in the USA South entering the season. First couple of matches will be Piedmont and William Peace. They'll host Piedmont and Buena Vista on Saturday. But despite the great turnover in their roster this year, and of course the change in coaching staff, Knights do have an opportunity to do some damage in the USA South once again this year after 2 very successful years to start their membership in the conference. They lost several key players, many due to graduation from last year's team. But again, do still return some very quality starters, including Piper Searle and Kaya Based, and who are doing a really solid job scoring-wise this year for the Knights, but other players like Roxy LeBaron, from a starter from last year's team, very, very quality player, high-quality player on both ends of the field. There's a tough pass that's going to go past her teammate and out of bounds, so the Knights will take control. Rare turnover from Randolph-Macon. Looks to be Bailey Bruce who now has control. Sorensen coming out of her goal just a little bit to offer Bruce some help. Sorensen still looking for some help. There's a couple of substitutes were made for the Knights as well. Looks like Lizzie Hill, freshman's in there. And there's a turnover from the Yellow Jackets. Back on the attack they go. It's a 2-on-3. Now just a 1-on-4 as another Yellow Jacket defender circled back to not cross that line at the 30-yard line. Knights trying to get settled here defensively. Oh, That was Mulligan in control. Now at the top, pressured by Ellie Patterson. Good steal from Patterson, trying to gain control now. Just won't get the steal, but good pressure applied. Now back down the middle. Good interception that time by Bailey Bruce, and Patterson in control. Looking to gain center. Pressure being applied now. And a penalty will be called on Macon that time. Good job by Patterson to shield the defender and keep control of it. Now Piper Searle in control. Right on top of that outer arc. Now it's Michaela Martin in control. Nice move to get towards the middle. And she's going to put it over top of the crossbar. And Macon looks to get there first. They will. So they'll grab possession with just 8.5 remaining in the final frame. Is whistled down. Contact was made just inside that arc. And this will be another free position opportunity for Randolph-Macon, trying to get to 20 on the evening. Nice pass back towards the goal line, then putting it past Sorensen once again. And Macon, just like that, has put 20 on the board to extend their advantage. Randolph making a few substitutions now, as we get now to just 7 minutes and 20 seconds on the clock, as it continues to roll down. SVU was able to, Knights were able to battle back there at the end of the third with a couple of goals from Kai Basin and Piper Searle. They'll be looking to do the same here towards the end of this quarter, as we are now over halfway home in the fourth. Ellie Patterson, I believe, again, or Reagan Bullock, rather, on the draw. Looks like she might win this one. Roxanne LeBaron trying to grab control. She's converged on by three Yellow Jackets now right at that line. And Randolph-Macon able to grab control. Lots of speed. This is Lowry. It's a feed back to the, towards the middle, but forced out by Mariela Perez. That pass goes towards the middle. Looked like Patterson could have intercepted it, but she couldn't get there in time. There's another move back towards the middle by Kemi McNeely. That pass was disrupted. Seconds remain on the shot clock. Anna Snoddy with a couple of goals to her name, trying to pick up the hat trick. This is Lowry back up top for McNeely. Almost left there by Maxwell, but she'll easily turn back and pick it up. Pressured by Bullock. Some good movement, but again, good defense this time by the Knights. 15 now left on the shot clock. And a good disruption again, as that was Kaya Bazin and waiting for it, but she can't get a hand on it. 2 seconds and one now, and they don't realize, and that'll be the shot clock violation against Randolph-Macon, as Cammy McNeely seemed to not realize that it was ticking down. As the Knights now will take possession with now under 5 minutes to go in regulation. Lizzie Hill's going to grab that towards the middle of the field. There's a stick check against her. Again by Lowry. She's been full throttle this entire game, but a really dangerous player on that offensive end. There's a good pass for McNeely down the middle, looking for an opening, but good defense there by Rocky LeBaron to cancel that opportunity. Big contact between one of the Yellow Jacket attackers and now Roxy LeBaron putting a shoulder in there and trying to get loose. But McNeely will be called. A green card assessed, and she'll go take a few moments on the sideline. LeBaron still in control for Southern Virginia. Pause there to signal that the clock should continue running. Roxy LeBaron now full throttle into the attacking zone. That'll allow the Knights to get set up offensively. Ellie Patterson now back behind for Bangerter. Here's a pass that went through everyone. There's Lizzie Hill applying pressure. Now Maddie Bird tries to pick it up. Perez, nice move to get through a couple of defenders and send it ahead looking for Ellie Patterson. Nice move by Patterson. Going to try and make her way through all those defenders herself. Then she loses it. Good defense by the Yellow Jackets. Send it back for Emma Taylor. Just 2:30 remaining on the clock. Time for perhaps a couple of more possessions each for the squads. There's a feed towards the middle. That was number 14. Annie Pruitt looking for another one. But she'll be given now a free position. Good shot and another score. That time Pruitt, I believe, after the initial pass from Evie McNeely. And it will be Annie Pruitt. I believe her first on the season if she hadn't already struck today. Came into today's game still looking for her first, but she's certainly got it now off of a nice feed from McNeely. 21 on the board now for the Yellow Jackets, a very strong fourth quarter again, despite switching out some of their starting players, but again, a team that has a lot of depth. One thing that the Knights will have to deal with this season, not having the depth they typically do, after the departure of quite a few players on last year's squad. This is Kinsey Poulsen able to grab control. Nice little move to duck under the stick check from McNeely. She's looking for some teammates, but she's being converged on by about four Yellow Jackets at the moment. So just opt back for Bailey Bruce. On the sideline, Bruce is going to find her way through a couple of defenders. Now looking for Ellie Patterson. He's got one in the middle. Scoops it up and scores. Piper Searle puts it in for her second. As Ellie Patterson was upended, trying to get it into the middle. Looks to be back on her feet under her own power, which is good to see. So a nice moment there. I don't think the foul occurred before the shot, and so they're going to wipe off the goal from Searle and give Ellie Patterson the opportunity here in the free position. He's going to be stopped by Emma Taylor. Tried to go low, perhaps between the legs. But a good challenge by Taylor as they try to clear this one out, but it's going to go out of bounds. Bailey Bruce was looking for Addison England. Able to move around a couple of defenders. Now send it towards Piper Searle. She tries to spin around. And there's a defender upended in the zone. But that'll do it for tonight's contest. There was a foul called before the end of play, though. So I think they'll give Piper Searle one more opportunity before the clock rolls down to zero. Might just have one more possession. 2 seconds down the clock. And that one will go wide. Piper still not able to convert on that free possession. That'll do it for tonight's contest. Randolph-Macon able to come away with a commanding victory tonight over your Southern Virginia Knights. It was a promising start for Southern Virginia, but they weren't able to match the high-octane offense of Randolph-Macon, who is going to cruise into their matchup back at home and start this homestand against Meredith and the start of conference play for them. The Knights also looking to start conference play this Saturday against Piedmont, as the Knights will fall to 2-2 on the season. Randolph-Macon now at 4-2. As previously mentioned, the Knights will next compete against Piedmont here at Knight Stadium on Saturday at 2 p.m. That will be broadcasted on Knights Broadcasting on YouTube. But again, we thank you for tuning in for this edition of Knights Broadcasting. Be sure to like, subscribe, leave a comment, let us know how we're doing, how we can improve your viewing experience. And we also appreciate the work of our production crew of Knights Broadcasting. Always do a fabulous job. And we wish you all a very pleasant evening. And as always, go Knights.